I got the opportunity, it's a big opportunity to me to talk with the Huawei executive, Ken Hu, and I really enjoy to share with you this talk and this conversation with him. But without further ado, let's do it now.
Perfect.
I think technology is very important to talk about how we are experiencing this period, you know, this time of pandemic. I think technology is really helping us to fight this virus.
Compared with the past virus like SARS or H1N1, I think now the situation is much worse than before. However, we're lucky now that we have much more advanced technology than a couple of years ago when we were in the past disease. Firstly, the super fast broadband, including the fixed broadband and the mobile broadband. Now, most of the people have to stay home, just like you and me. And the shops were closed, factories were closed, schools were closed. However, we are still connected with each other. We're still connected with the world, with the support of the broadband. Just like the video conference we have today. Yeah, we can talk with each other just like face to face. This is really a really amazing experience. So I could imagine how the world would like if we don't have the broadband today. And the artificial intelligence, during this pandemic, we've seen that the many scientists are working with the help from artificial intelligence to better understand the virus, to identify the better solution with medicine, and even to speed up the process of the vaccine development. For the healthcare, one impressive case for me is that normally a doctor needs to spend 12 to 15 minutes to review a CT scan. That's a normal case. However, during the pandemic, there are so many CT scans that they have to review, and that's a huge amount of workload for the doctors. And they have to spend lots of time on CT scan review, and that will reduce their time taking care of their patients. So a couple of weeks ago, we worked with the hospitals in China to deploy a artificial intelligence application on the cloud. And with the with the AI service, now in the hospital, the doctors can use the AI to review the scan. And it reduced the time from 12 minutes to 10 seconds. And the result shows that it's as accurate as a human doctor. So this is an amazing case. And I think the 12 minutes to 10 seconds, not just the save of the time. In some of the case, it's actually the save of lives.
I want to talk to you also about 5G, because talking about trust like before, I know that you built in 3 days the 5G, the complete architecture in radio network and core network for the hospital in Wuhan. Is that a real thing, Ken?
In China, the government had to build 2 emergency hospital, field hospital, in just 10 days. That's very fast. However, you have to provide the broadband connectivity to the hospital, because now all the hospitals rely so much on the broadband connectivity. So if we did that in the traditional way with the fiber, it would take weeks or even months. Obviously, it was not acceptable in such an urgent situation. So we get help from the 5G. And we worked with the telecom operators in China to build couple of 5G base stations across the campus of the emergency field hospital. And we finished all the job in just 3 days. With the 5G broadband connectivity, doctors in the hospital were able to work with the hospitals in different cities in China or even in different countries remotely to share the data, because during the pandemic, there are lots of, you know, real-time image and the videos consists of huge amount of data. So they can share the data freely with the, you know, 5G broadband connectivity. And that greatly helped them to exchange the ideas, to help each other to identify the real situation and to identify the better solution for the patients. So this is very impressive.